very overwhelming deciding how to start a new language, especially if you have never learned another language before. So if you're monolingual, or maybe you kind of started studying another language but stopped, or studied in high school, like you probably have if you did your school in America and maybe didn't really learn a whole lot and are now trying to learn that language on your own. A big question that I hear so many people asking is, where do I start? Do I start with grammar? Do I start with vocabulary? Do I start with speaking? What do I start with? So this is our topic for today. And the short answer is, you just need to start. So regardless of what you start with, you just need to jump in and start. And I know maybe that's not all that helpful. You're like, I don't know where to start. How can I just jump in and start? So if you have access to vocabulary, like if you're using any kind of app or software that you have, you're using Duolingo or Rosetta Stone or any other app like that, start there. Start acquiring some vocabulary and then go from there. Find a grammar textbook that you like, or enroll in a class that you like. There really is not a single method that is the best or the most effective for everyone, because what works best for you is not necessarily what works best for me or what works best for someone else. So you're really gonna have to just get in there and start figuring it out as you go. And so that's why I say just start somewhere. Start with some vocabulary, start with some grammar, start with anything you have, and then make adjustments as you go through it. And I think that you'll find that as you learn grammar or vocabulary or speaking or reading or writing, whatever it is, you're really gonna learn a little bit of everything, because it's really not possible to study vocabulary without learning a little bit of grammar. Like if you're studying Spanish and you learn the word ser and you learn the word estar, you're gonna learn a little bit of the grammar by learning that vocabulary. So it's all connected, and that's why it doesn't matter too much where you start. Do start with the basics. That's probably gonna help you the most. You're not limited to that. There are so many different approaches, and you just need to find the one that is right for you. So that's why, start anywhere you can. And then really what I want you to ask yourself, instead of where should I start, is where should I go? So start in whatever you have access to. If you have a book, crack it open and start reading. If you have an app, start working on it, and then think about, where am I going? What are my goals that I want to achieve in my language? And what do I need? So as you're going through that, as you're reading or as you're studying, whatever you're doing, think about, okay, I get this, but I don't get this. So ask yourself questions as you're learning, and then use that to guide your education. So as you go through, you'll sort of develop your own strategies. And while I do have so many strategies that I share with you guys that are my techniques for learning, they are not necessarily going to be perfect for you. My hope is that you'll see some of the things I do, and maybe you'll like them, maybe you'll incorporate them, or maybe you'll find a way to adjust them, or maybe it'll give you a different idea entirely that works for you. So that's really the goal, and that's really what I want you guys to take away from this, is that you just need to jump in and start, and you need to ask yourself questions about what you understand. So as you're going through something and you're like, this doesn't make sense, don't just stop at this doesn't make sense. Think about, why doesn't this make sense? And then do some research on that. That's where you're going next. That's what you need to study next. Think about your overarching goals and look at, okay, how do I get from where I am to where I want to go? And that's what you need to do. And those are the questions that you need to research when you go online or go to speak with a partner or a tutor or whatever it is. And that's how you can really guide your own learning. And really, once you get some of those basics down and you get some of the vocabulary down and you want to start working with someone, It definitely is helpful to have someone to practice with, like if you work with a partner or a tutor, or like if you go on italki or something like that, it is an excellent resource and that I actually experimented with a little bit with my Spanish, because you guys know that I do teach Spanish on here and I speak Spanish, but my level of Spanish is it's an advanced level, I would say, but it is by no means perfect. I am still trying to improve. So just so that you guys can see, you guys can hear and kind of get an idea, mi nivel de español es que yo puedo hablarlo y yo puedo decir lo que necesito y puedo comunicarme con casi cualquier persona, pero no siempre tengo el vocabulario que necesito tener o que quiero para expresarme. Entonces, con eso todavía estoy trabajando y todavía estoy estudiando y siempre voy a estar mejorando, porque no hay un límite en lo que podemos aprender. So you should have a little bit of an idea, like my level of Spanish is such that I am comfortable speaking, I'm comfortable saying pretty much anything that I need to, but I still need more practice. So one thing that I have experimented with lately is going on italki, which I actually did for one of my Spanish classes, and I did it because I was required to do a conversation with a person from Latin America. So I did that and I was able to practice speaking, and it's really a cool platform that if you have not tried, I would really recommend that you give that a chance. If you just don't know where to start, that is one way that you can just kind of jump in and you can get some help to guide your learning. And it's probably better if you at least have a little bit of the basic vocabulary down, like so that you can practice. I would definitely recommend having a decent foundation before you go into speaking with someone, unless you can get someone who, let's say you speak English and you're learning Spanish, you get someone who speaks fluent English and fluent Spanish, then of course they can help you with more translation and they can help you learn that way. So that's one way that you can just jump in and start. And if you are interested in that, there is a link in the description bar down below where you can get a discount for your italki lesson when you click on the link and sign up for a lesson with any tutor of your choice. So just one way that you can jump in and start. Again, everyone is going to have a different preference and different needs and all of that, which is kind of one of the reasons it's such a cool platform, because you can choose which teacher you want to work with. So I really like that aspect of it, and I'm planning to use this platform for my French as well, which is a very, very limited right now. I'm not going to even try to speak it because I just know I'm not ready to do that. And anyway, so what to take away from this lesson? Jump in and start somewhere. Start with a book, study some grammar, start with an app, start with vocabulary, start with a tutor, start with whatever you have access to. And the more resources you have available to you, the more you can customize your own learning. And if you can afford the opportunity to work with someone, then I definitely would recommend working with someone. If you have that and you really need help getting started, that will expedite the process. But you can also do it on your own. It's just going to require a little bit more work and research on your part. But whichever route you decide to go with, you definitely can do it. You just need to determine what it is you want to do and your goal that you want to reach, and figure out how you're going to get there along the way, and be flexible through your process of learning. And yeah, I'll see you guys back here next time. Ciao!